Hey, what's going on, guys? In this video, work smarter, not harder. HK USPC chambered in 9mm. All right, so what am I talking about here? Well, I want to show you this phenomenal handgun right here that I'm going to attempt to carry because it is the colder, you know, temperature months now. I know I'm playing a little bit of musical chairs with my carry gun, which is something that is unheard of. But because I'm getting older and maybe I'm going through something, I am trying different carry guns. I'm going to admit it. For the last few months, I've been changing it up. And it's not like me to do that. But I don't know, maybe it's something that I've never done before. So it's new to me. So it excites me. I'm trying all these different things, you know, so on and so forth. I don't know, but I promise I'm going to settle on a carry gun, hopefully soon. We'll see how this goes. But anyways. What do I mean by work smarter, not harder? So this came from a younger generation shooter that saw me shooting this at the range. So I got this because I want to try to carry an HK USP as a CCW. I don't know if it's going to work out, but I do want to try to carry it. And this is chambered in 9mm. While I was at the range at the gun club shooting this, I was talking to this new gen shooter, I like to call them. And he noticed that this was a USP and he's like, oh, wow. HK USP, that's cool, man. It's like, that's an old gun. I'm like, wait, what? You think this is old? He's like, yeah, that's an old gun. He's like, oh, what are you doing with it? And I told him, like, oh, I was going to try to carry it. And he said, oh, man. And while we were talking, he said that, oh, you got to work smarter, not harder. Work smarter. So what does he mean by that? Get a striker. He said that to you. You should be getting a striker. And, of course, I have plenty of striker-fired handguns in the stable. And all the, you know, most of them I just leave in a safe. I mean, I could probably start selling them off because I don't even touch them. I mean, I have the Glock Model 45 with the Acro on it. That one is a little bit different. You know, I tried my hand at that. I did well with it, but I eventually just put it away. I don't know. It just, Glocks don't do anything for me. I got used to the red dot and I was like, I got my fill. I kind of like iron sights, you know, old habits die hard. So I put that one away. But what this new gen shooter was telling me, and he had a CZ, I don't know what the model is because I don't know anything about CZ handguns, but it had some crazy suppressor height sights, and he had his red dot optic on his. It was like a white, I don't know, grayish, like colored slide. I don't know, it was an interesting looking handgun, but nothing that I am interested in. And he's saying, well, these are the guns that, you know, people use. So he kind of went off on this, you know, little lecture to me. This like 20-something-year-old guy. Anyways, that is true that when I go to the public ranges, gun clubs, you know, I would say 80%, maybe even a little bit more, 80% or so, are shooting strikers. I see a good amount of guys shooting 1911s. Some people shooting the DASA still. And that's about it. I literally do not see anyone shooting revolvers at any range. I mean, no, that's not true. I mean, a couple weeks ago, there was an older gentleman at the range, and he was shooting his Smith & Wesson 3-inch. I think it was a 686 Performance Center, I believe. He was the first revolver shooter I saw had seen in such a long time. And I had my revolvers with me, so we got talking. That could be a whole nother video. He was a very cool guy, and I let him shoot my MR73 in Mongoose, and he really appreciated that. He had such a huge smile on his face. He loved it. But I was, you know, very happy to allow him that opportunity to try out those type of revolvers. Anyways, so this you know, new gen shooter I was talking to was saying, well, double action, single action. He's like, that is not efficient at all, you know. So that's an old, you know, concept. It's an old technology. You know, everything is striker. I was like, oh, okay, all right, well, whatever. But he was like, well, regardless, that is a damn cool looking handgun. So at least he, you know, recognized that. So I thought that was kind of funny. So that's why I picked the title to be, you know, work smarter, not harder. So he thinks that this kind of gun right here, you're working harder, which is the truth. Okay. But I am willing to work harder, whatever, and to shoot a DASA. I put this rubber band, HK rubber band, back on the grip here just for the fun of it, but let's take that off. All right. So I think this is a phenomenal handgun. Yes, it is a double action, single action. We'll decock it like that. And we'll just leave it like this. So no safeties to mess with unless you want to. I don't know why you would. But that is a double action, right? We'll go like double action first, which is very heavy, to single action. And that double action is a consistent pull to the rear that's pretty damn heavy, but it reminds me of any of my like stock revolvers. Now, we can't put that up to a Mongoose or a MR73 because those triggers are totally tuned. But this does remind me of a J-Frames trigger. So I am used to something like that. You just kind of roll right through it and you just deal with it. Then when it goes to single action, you know, it's much more easier to, handle. But anyways, so from the perspective of that younger generation shooter, he believed that this is an inefficient type of handgun because you have to pull through that heavy trigger pull. He said, I would never do that. But for me personally, I took this out to the range. I was doing controlled pairs with like boom, boom, like that. And, you know, I was fine with it because I was shooting a Beretta PX4 Storm Compact. That one has also been put away as well in favor of a USP. I don't know. I saw the USP. I was like, you know what? I want to try this one because this brings me back to when I first got into guns. My first gun ever was an HK USP in stainless with a stainless slide, a full size 40 caliber. I wish I had kept that one because that was my first gun. But anyways, this one right here, I mean, this is a badass looking handgun. It's blocky. Yes, it's probably difficult to, you know, conceal carry, but I started to do it. And it's, you know, it's not too bad. I guess I'm just used to having things stuffed, you know, at the 4 o'clock position and just feeling that way. But this is a phenomenal handgun. It shoots very well. Out of the box, of course, it's 100%. I think it can handle anything. I even put plus P pluses through this of Winchester Ranger T's 127 grain plus P plus. You know, I mean, the recoil is just a little bit more snappy. Not really, but it's a lot louder. I'm not going to put a lot of plus P pluses through this. But since I have quite a bit of that ammunition that I never put in any of my other 9mm, I know the USP is rated for plus P plus handling. So I was like, let's grab some Ranger T's in plus P plus and see how it works. And it works just fine. Never choked up. All different kinds of target ammunition have been put through this. And it's a phenomenal handgun. Of course, very blocky. Now, this holster here kind of looks like a Milt Sparks VersaMax 2. However, it is not. It's a clone, a copy. So the quality is not there. See this? This is splitting at the bottom. But for now, because I'm just kind of testing it, it does work out pretty well. But I don't know if this is going to split. But it's been sewn down here. But it's kind of, see how that's splitting at the bottom? So anyways, it does work like a VersaMax 2. You know, and I put the gun in the holster just like that, inside the waistband at the 4 o'clock position, and it actually works out pretty good. There's not many off-the-shelf like USP holsters out there because it's not a popular gun anymore, at least. But I was able to get this off. I think it was eBay for I don't know how much. Wasn't that much? It might have been like, well, no, wait, maybe it was $50. This might have been a $50 holster. So I said, why not? Just for now, because I want to see if I could do this, carry this. I don't know if I'm going to really carry the USP, but I got this anyways. So it's so kind of like a no-name holster that's a copy of the VersaMax 2. Other than that, you guys know the magazine release is a paddle right here. So normally I utilize my trigger finger to release the magazine. It is different than pushing a button that I'm used to, all you know, for the most part. But it's weird. When I pick up a USP, I automatically know to release the mag, I got to press the paddle right there. But it's a good-looking pistol. You call it the Jack Bauer gun. You call it the Blood Diamond gun, whatever you want. You know, is it accurate? Yeah, it's pretty accurate. But I'm not looking for pinpoint accuracy. If for a self-defense firearm, it definitely fits the bill. So ultra-reliable, go-to-war handgun chambered in 9mm. Not 45, what the hell? Yeah, I'm kind of like, I mean, I like a 45, but as I'm getting older, because my hand, this hand right here, I can shoot more 9mm. When I shoot 45, especially compact 45s, it just starts to aggravate my hand. When I shoot 357 Magnums, same thing happens. And this all started when I started shooting 460 mags and 454 Casull. I don't know. I did something to my freaking hand. Months. This is like months ago, so it's still going. So, just getting older. I don't know. But anyways, shooting 9mm, not a problem. My hand's just fine. So, yeah, I figured I'd just go with a 9mm. Everybody else's ammunition cost is reasonable, over 45 ACP. So I can take this to the range, you know, a ton. So I do have quite a bit of 9mm. I do have quite a bit of 45 ACP for handgun rounds. Oh, and 38 specials and 357 Magnum. But anyways, what do you guys think of the HK USP? It's classic, I believe. And what do you think about that comment? You know, work smarter, not harder. So this is not a smart gun. You know, you got to pull through that double action. That's working too hard. I don't think so, but I get what he's saying. I get what that shooter was saying, you know, because the striker fire are very consistent, and yes, they are easier to shoot, and maybe you can be faster with them, what have you, but I guess I'm old, and I just like older type of platforms. So I'm going to run with this one for a little bit. I know it doesn't have night sights. I have night sights for this, but I don't know. I haven't put them on just yet. I'm not sure if I'm going to. It just depends. Also, I think it's going to be a little difficult to get these off. So, because the tool I have, I don't think it's going to be able to. And I think you have to file it down a little bit to make it fit this dovetail. So I'm not going to mess with this just, you know, with the sights just yet. But there you go. HK USP compact chambered in 9mm. I think this is a pretty cool handgun. You know, despite it being quote-unquote old. Old platform, DASA, I think with anything, with training, you'll get the hang of it, and there will be no issue. All right, guys, leave some comments below. Let me know what you think, and as always, stay safe and check 360 often. Later.